What's going on, everybody? Y'all know what it is, man. My mother named me Larry Jordan. This is another episode of the Just My Russell Opinion Show. Haven't been here in a while. Got some things to talk about. Got some things to laugh at. Y'all know how we do. It's officially cuffing season, so we're gonna let some people come in. Big up all my big girls who about to keep all the skinny fellas real warm and homely this upcoming season. So we gonna put that first song out to you guys while we let some people come in. You know what I'm saying? Y'all know I like a little music and thing. Let's do it.
I wanna dedicate this song to all the lovers tonight. I expect that might be the whole world, because everybody needs something or someone to love. When it's cold outside,
girl,
who are you holding?
All summer, don't find a man. Now you're getting.
She's telling me about the things that a girlfriend's got. What she ain't got. And she wants me to go out and get them for her.
Good.
But girl, I can't be in two places at once.
Got it so hanged up already, man.
If you think you're lonely, man.
Morning, cuz. Morning, cuz. Not late. Skinny niggas is getting dissed too. What's up, Xavier? Gotta get that cuffing season tune on. You know what I'm saying?
I ain't there to rub your back. Just remember, I made it known back.
Summer done. All of a sudden, in the winter, you start wanting breakfast. In the summertime, I run more breakfast. I'm gone. You're doing everything. And then once you're done, cuffing season, you're all going to cook the breakfast. Now, until she tells you, you can't come back. Perfect tune. Zanzia morning. All my ladies, 160 and up, it's your time. That's on a slow jam radio station right now. Like, This is preparation. Winter to come. And look outside. Look outside. You get spoiled. It's all October, close to November, and the tree's still green. And I have enough time to even catch up. A little bit more. I'm sorry, baby. No. You can't run up this tree this year. No third belly for you in the morning. No, you stop appreciating the third belly and the third chin. I'm done. Y'all like my slow jams? Green leaves everywhere. That was the Lord telling you, you know you done fucked up, right? You know, you was fucking with that skinny chick all summer. Her little string up she eyes, going to the fets. Yeah. Now it's winter time. She can't cook nothing. She bubble goose. Got all of y'all cold. You want that big girl. Big girl give that sloppy toppy. You can't get the sloppy toppy from the skinny girl. Morning, Whitney. Morning, Whitney. Big up everybody that got it locked in, man. Just a little fun before we start. You know how we do it, roller coaster type thing. Up and down, fun seriousness, realness. You know, some mockery, but I don't make mockery on people's lives or anything like that. So, welcome to the Just My Rassle Opinion Show. My mother named me Larry Jordan. I always got to start with my disclaimer. This is my show about my opinion. Opinions are like assholes. Everyone has one, and most are full of shit. You don't have to agree with my opinion. It is what it is. We all have them. We don't need to be enemies. We don't need to fight or have any type of negativity towards each other. If we agree to disagree, we could just agree to disagree and leave it at that. We don't need to keep it and bring it on to nothing else, all right? So that's what it is. And on another note, before I start, real shit, real talk, because y'all know I like to have my fun, but I like to be serious. As I told you, this is going to be a roller coaster ride. I need to say rest in peace to two people we lost as a community this week. And it was Mr. Schofield, big up Jizz, big up James, and an old classic of mine, Lisa, April Rains. Man, shut up. So, rest in peace, April. Rest in peace to James. I put up his service information on my page, and April's service was Friday, so big up to them. Great people, lost too soon. Yeah, can't start this without paying my respects to them, you know what I'm saying? So, this show has been brought to you by Bearskin All Natural. Check out Bearskin All Natural for your all natural skincare, soaps, beer butter, shea butter, all them things. Check it out. Hold on. Dude, not now. The fuck? You like, you want my attention or some shit? Big up everybody, as I said earlier, as we started out having a good time. You know, cuffing season is officially here. You're waking up. You got frost on the car. I had to put on my seat warmers the other day. You know what I'm saying? So, a nice cup of soup has been going down very well these days. Again, if you're in the Boston, if you're in the Massachusetts, if you're up in the northeast part of the United States, y'all know shit's weird. Like, right now, we're supposed to be raking up a whole shit of leaves. Yeah, we're raking up, but not the amount that we're supposed to be. I'm looking out. I'm still seeing green trees. Bless King. I know I'm supposed to link you a long time. Big up yourself, Mystic, every time. Nephew, Power Surge, big up yourself. I seen your show. Shit was litty, son. Big up yourself with the Rudy Rowdy. One of them. Big up yourself on that. So, we're going to talk about parties. We're going to talk about some shit with Biden, and we're going to talk about things in the community. So let's start off with these with a little bit of the atmosphere, because y'all know I ain't been here for a while. I seen a lot of people doing things, trying things, and I'm like, wait a minute, what's going on? Again, I know that I'm a little bit out of the loop. I've been trying to do some business things, but we've been in a pandemic now for 2 years. Again, this is just my rational opinion. So now things are starting to get back into the norm, right? Just had Miami Carnival. You know, I'm not going to do no reviews or nothing. I wasn't there too, but a couple people was just like, yo, L, it was whack. Honestly, I heard that the highlight of Miami for a lot of people who was telling me was that Mastermind and Legend and Warlock was the ones really doing their thing out there. But that's a whole nother topic. But, you know, Miami Carnival went down. A lot of people left, came back. To me, this was the opportunity for people to expand their creative mind. Maybe come back and do a party, even if it's a party with the same names and, I mean, the same people at the same places, the same names, the same concepts. Nigga, y'all was down for 2 years, and I'm still looking at Barbados versus Trinidad. I'm still looking at shit that, like, listen, shit's about to be as old as me. Like, do a fucking Guyana versus fucking Grenada and play jab. Some shit like, I'm just like, I'm looking at, I'm just surprised I ain't see a Dons and Divas. I'm just surprised I ain't see a Dons. Because it's just like, wait, y'all came out to do the same thing. And it's not a hit at just the Lion promotion event, Barbados versus Trinidad. It's everything. It's everything. And as I say before, to me, if I'm wrong, say I'm wrong, because I'm not at a lot of these events, but the Flyers be looking better than the damn establishments. Whoever's making these flyers for the Friday night at Unity, the flyer look better than fucking Unity. Just my rational opinion. I'm like, yo, this is a nice fucking flyer. Too bad I know what inside Unity looks like. Like, shit, like, some whoever y'all have making these flyers, y'all should have that creative expression to apply some paint on the fucking walls. To apply this creative and hey, you know what you know that tone that you use for this flyer? Yeah, let us paint off. Like, you use some of these younger dudes to build. I'ma even be more with that. I'ma even be more with that. Y'all know me. I don't give a rascal. If it's the truth, it's the truth. If it's not, it's still just my rascal opinion. I can literally say from the first ever Barbados vs. Trinidad, I was part of it. I was in it, right? The clash, the dance, everything. So now that I see Barbados vs. Trinidad coming up, I'm like, word, this looks cool. They don't have no Bears in Boston. I'm not on it. Not trying to be on it. I don't even like going to Unity. Big up. It was nothing on me DJing or anything like that. I see Warlock. I see Dooley. And I see Venom. Boston don't got no Bajor sounds? Vital ain't it? I don't know. You know, there might be some little discrepancies between. Because, you know, everybody got their little beefs and their little clashes amongst each other. But I'm just like, right now. And I'm also going off a conversation I heard in a barbershop where that was mentioned. And then it's like, damn, why are they always bringing these older dudes? Again, it's a new realm. It's a new entity. It's a new time. So these younger dudes, people, patrons of the clubs, they're into the Coogees, the Kareems, What's Goldfinger and them? Dynamite Song. They're into, you know what I'm saying? Charlie Sun, CJ. They're into them younger dudes. So now you have these younger patrons into the clubs, and they're like, damn, I really don't want to hear the older names because I don't want people to think that I'm taking shots at people. And again, I go back to when I was a kid, and I used to be like, yo, Richie, get the fuck off. Let the younger dudes play. Blah, 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 blah. It is just a circle. It is just, it's a vibe. And these kids nowadays have who they want to listen to. So now when, again, I'm going off of what people hear. I'm just willing to say it. When you hear the youngsters like, and I quote, I was like, yeah, it's Warlock, it's Dooley from New York, and it's Venom from New York. And then one of the dudes was like, a bunch of old niggas playing. And I was like, ooh. You know what I'm saying? In my head, I'm like, where's Vital? As far as Bear Jens, Boston, hook him up, I'm just like, where's Vital? You know Warlock's going to be there. He represent Barbados. You know me. I don't even want to be in Unity. I just think you. When I walk into Unity and K's nowadays, I feel like I have asthma and eczema. So I don't fucking like going in there. You know what I'm saying? So I understand probably why I wasn't called for the event. But I shed no hard feelings on any event that I'm not called on. Half the time I end up going anyway. Boston's too small. Let some of these young niggas eat. I understand too about, you know, bringing in another entity from out of town and opened up your horizons and shit. But these youngsters, 35 under, is who's feeding the promoters right now. Let's be real.
You know what I'm saying? The Mod Sounds crews, and you know what I'm saying? The clean crews, and the trendy crews, and the young niggas doing their thing right now and building their vibe. And that's the thing. So right now they don't want to hear me per se, and Richie per se, and bringing up niggas who was in the first clash from back in 1995, you know what I'm saying? Like, niggas know Dooley. Dooley is a great fucking DJ, but nobody 30, 35 in Boston is really like, they're like, who the fuck is Dooley? You know what I'm saying? Like, who? He's an international DJ, but when you're 30, when you're 21 to 35, you're really looking like, who the fuck is Dooley? You know what I mean? Nigga like me now, I'm like, yo, I know Dooley, no tunes. You know old tunes, you know new tunes. And like I said, all these DJs are capable of fucking up a party, just like me. They could play for the younger crowd, but these younger crowds have their familiar faces that they want to see and that they want to hear. You know what I'm saying? So don't let what make you break you. Don't let what make you break you. And you can take that however you want it as far as, if you think I'm throwing a shot, I'm not throwing a shot at nobody. I'm 30. Bring them back, please. I'm just saying. I'm just going off of, again, what the youngsters was talking around me. And they were just like, yeah, they're cool. Bunch of old niggas. just. And in my, and again, to end it on this, I was just wondering, if you're talking about Bajans and you're Boston and where Vito? Why is there Warlock from Boston? Where's Vito? I love the newbies, but bring me the oldies too. Is that a personal preference? Are we still talking about DJs here? Let me stop. Think of yourself, Shaniqua. Yo, what's going on, Bobby Steels? What up, Steph? What's going on, little sis? Chantel? Desmond, Wagwan, Charisse Haley. All right, let's get on this little money topic real quick, right? Quick little money thing. I don't know if y'all heard about Biden and his inheritance tax, but anybody who deal with a little money and know anything, right? So check this shit out, right? So say your mother, say your family owns a house. Morning, Melvin. Say your family owns a house. And now everybody went around, so test me. Say your mother owns a house and she, God forbid, passes away. Right? Joe Biden has now brought back a tax that's saying basically your mother's death was a transaction. And within that transaction, there must be a tax, which is 33%. So let's just round off some numbers here. Say your mother passed away and left you a property for $100,000, right? If you don't have $33,000 to pay in taxes, the government can now come for your shit. Her death is considered a transaction, like she made a play. Like her passing and giving you that shit was the play. What the fuck is that? All right, so let's even say more, because $100,000 ain't shit in Boston. Let's be real. Let's look at another big number. Let's say your mother left you a property, a three-family house, and the three-family house was about $1 million, right? Morning, Toya. If you don't have $330,000 to pay on those death taxes, you could lose the fucking house. And those are more realistic numbers here on where we live and how shit is. Because a three-family, you could, you know, sell a condo for damn near $400,000 now. You could sell a floor. They call them condos now, but they're floors. All right, big man, cuz, let's say you got a three-family. Say what something, you know that's yours. That's exactly the numbers there. Say that was $1 million for the three-family. Boom. Now, if they said, oh, there was a will that was proposed, right? And mommy gave you a floor. Mommy gave your sister a floor. Mommy gave a next relative a floor. Now each of y'all are getting taxed on the market value on each said floor, because each floor is now a said transaction.
that is fucked up. I voted for this cunt, but I'm like, whoa. But again, what y'all need to understand a little bit is this is the money he needs to recoup from all the other fuckery, like the stimulus checks that we've been getting and all that. He has to get this money back in some type of way. Hold on, I just found this shit up on Forbes.com, right? It said, the current rule provides a step-in basis upon death. That means if a person owns an asset that has appreciated, the basis of the property steps up to the fair market value at the time of death. So if Tina owns a portfolio of stocks that is worth $2.2 million that she purchased at various times since 1970 for a total of $200,000 and leaves the portfolio for her children, they would receive the portfolio at a basis of $2.2 million. But if they sold the $2.2 million, they would pay no capital gains taxes, all right? If they sold it the following year with a little gain of $2.5 million, they would now have $300,000 long-term gains, which is taxed at the preferential rates. Add your children to the deed of the house like you are the owners. Also, wills are old. Put it in a trust. Yes and no. The trust part, I agree with. The deed part is bullshit. Because again, in a marriage, if the husband dies and the wife gets the shit, the wife still owes the taxes and vice versa. So this is basically the same shit. If the parents pass and pass it along to the kids, fuck you. You didn't earn. There's earned taxes. There's death taxes. Soon from now, they're gonna tax us to fucking breathe. I say it as a joke, but what the fuck? They're already containing air. They're already fucking trying to contain air. On a carryover basis, that's why I didn't want that shit. Carryover basis. The proposed rule would mandate that the heirs would take on or carry over the basis of the descendant. In addition, the proposed rule would make the death a transaction. Thus, in the example above, the heirs would have the basis of the $200,000. In addition, they would have to pay capital gains taxes on the $2 million gain. Worse, if this gain took their adjusted gross income over $1 million, they would pay ordinary income rates on the capital gain plus the net investment income tax for a total, y'all ready? For a total of 43.4%. You know it's 40, taking away 43% of your shit. The cost under proposed rule goes from zero under step up. Let me start over. This cost under the proposed rule goes from zero under a step up to $868,000 under the carryover basis. But hold on, it gets worse. These examples above do not include the state income taxes. In the Treasury Green Book, the Treasury indicates that the income would be taxable income to the descendant on the federal gift or estate tax return, or on a separate capital gain return. This is on, I will post the link, but this is Forbes.com. This means that there would be effectively two or even three death taxes. The federal capital gains, the possible state capital gains, and the federal estate taxes. All of this because your mother or your father worked hard to get a piece of property. We all want to pass up our shit to our children. But we're passing up our shit to our children to put them in debt. To put them in misery, because you know if you get something from your parents and then it's taken away, you're going to feel like shit. Because all you're going to be like, all I did was receive this property and now I owe $300,000 in taxes? What the fuck? How are we going to live? They're going to take away, we ain't going to have no social security. We're going to die of taxes
and bad health. It does not make any sense. I just wanted to bring that to the forefront because a lot of us, I know a lot of my peoples right now into real estate, getting their real estate license, making moves because we know that we all have a mentality of generational wealth. We all are thinking beyond just trying to be rich, right? So, as you know, more money, more problems. As you know, the more that you think that you can make, the more that the fucking government is going to take. Even like the poor man, the more overtime you make, it's like, why work so much? You got to set your standards to a certain amount of overtime. Because if you bust your ass and go over this number, you work like 100 hours overtime, they're going to tax you to a point where they're going to take more than you fucking make. So it doesn't make sense to do that shit. So now, if your mother or your father or somebody in your family work their tails to the knuckles and grind their shit to the point where they got themselves a property that's worth some fucking value on that general generational wealth that can they can pass on to the sons and the grandsons and shit. Nah, I'm not passing them on generational wealth. I'm passing them on a fucking debt. Half of us don't even know. Take it from me, when my mother passed, a lot of people, when that death comes, they don't even know the next step of the insurance or paying for the funeral, having all these. They don't know the legalities of that shit. So now, when you get something of this plateau where you're like, word. Because some of us have the mentality of, nah, this is the fucking property of the family. I'm going to keep this in the family. I'm going to make it work. I'm going to have this so my kids and da-da-da-da-da. And then some of us will just be like, well, my family needs to hustle. We need to sell this shit. You sell the house. If you don't take that money and do something with it, capital gains in your cunt. Take it from me. I learned it the hard way. Flipped something when I was real young. I flipped the house, nigga. Made a little 20 G's profit. Thinking, I got 20 G's in the bank. Letting it sit there. Nigga, that's the first time I ever heard of capital gains. Nigga, yo, you know what it's like when you got 20 G's in the bank and these niggas taking 9? Just because you didn't do nothing with it? Because I want to sit my money in the bank. It's a fucked up fact. So now, if your parents die, you can have, if your parents die and leave you something, you can have federal capital gains, state capital gains, and federal estate taxes on your cunt. This is America. So inheritance is now taxable. Yes, I know you're probably now coming in here. Inheritance, the death of the person is now seen as a transaction. To answer your question in a fucked up terms, death is now a business transaction. How about those Celtics? That pissed me off so much, I said that is what I was going to talk about today in my JMRO show. Because I have a lot of friends now in properties. I have a lot of friends now who are acquaintances or people that I know who's happened to take on a lot of responsibilities from this COVID shit. Parents passed away. Parents putting the houses in their names because they're not able to do the things that they were capable of doing 2 years ago. You know what I mean? Just, I know people going through this shit. Do they know? Morning. Do they know the amount of shit that's gonna come with them just trying to be responsible, trying to keep? Because we all see the gentrification around us, so we're like, yeah, let's try to keep this valuable property in our family's name. I'm just speaking of like any common man, right? All right, let's say you're a construction worker. I'm just a construction worker. I lived here my whole life with my family. Did not know the ins and outs of the mortgages and the second mortgages and the equity. I didn't know nothing about that shit. She passed. She said in her will it was going to be passed on to me. What the fuck you mean I owe $330,000 in taxes because the market value of this property is $1 million? Just because that she put it in my name, now I have a fucking cunt hole of debt.
And again, that $330,000 is just the federal shit. Who knows about the state tax? The state, a state, not the state. So you have the state tax, and then you have an estate, a federal estate, E-S-T-A-T-E tax. So when and where can you ever win in this country? You become a millionaire, they take 60% of your fucking earnings, yo. You know, you win the lottery, they take 60% of your fucking winnings. Now if you're dead, you're sore. So from now on, you're shite, they're going to take 60% of your shite. I'm sorry, not 60, I'm wrong. It's 60-40. I get 60, they get 40. I'm sorry, I was saying it wrong numbers. It's 40. But you know still, that's damn near half of your money. It's not 60, it's 40. But it's half of your fucking money. You win $1 million, you're only going to get $600,000. You become a millionaire, you only have $600,000. You need 3 million before you are really a millionaire. It used to be 2, but let's be real. After they tax your cunt and all that. So doesn't matter. All these people, when you win your big money and you get your 5 million and your whatever, nigga, take away 40% one fucking time just because you have a heartbeat. Don't ask why. Because if I go and I take shit from niggas, they call that extortion. When they take it from you, they call it a tax. And there's no legal law in any of our laws that we have, our constitution. There is nothing that states that you have to pay taxes. But yet and still, you have to pay taxes. It wasn't. You know I'm about to reach out to my accountant. Go ahead, Forbes.com. It's on Forbes. I've seen it on Bloomberg. I've seen it on all the accredited major shit. It's real. I don't give a fuck if they took 10%. I'm pissed off. Yo, I'm telling you, when I be getting my check, I still don't know who the fuck FICO is, man. I hate that nigga, yo. I be like, yo, who the fuck is FICO? Why he keep taking money from me? Chester, big it yourself. See you in a few. 40%. If you ever seen one of those interviews with Boosie and Vlad, Boosie was talking straight about it. He's like, yo, do you know what it's like? Larry is back with another one. I'm just talking. I ain't crack on nobody. We having grown man's conversation, grown people's conversation. You know what I'm saying? I just want all my people, because a lot of my people's on that business shit. Now, mind you, if you're a small business owner, small business owner, that inheritance tax can fuck with your businesses if your shit is not done properly. If your shit is not LLC'd, if your shit is not insured, they could come back and take your business just because your parents decided to give you what they worked for. Good morning, Mika. Good morning, Mika. Yo, it's just so fucked up how you could be put in a fucked up position. Your whole livelihood could be fucked up off of your parents trying to help you. Who has $330,000 just laying there just in case? Legally. You know what I mean? And then they say, oh, you can be on payment plan and everything. What type of payment plan that you could put your app on a black man level, that you could put a black man on, that he is comfortably just going to be like, okay, yep, I have this big... Like, only person I ever knew with a big debt over their head like that is Miss K. After she got sued. If I would have had that lawsuit, that shop would have been gone. K's Oasis would have been gone. I'd have cleared that debt, nigga. But imagine that. You're just sitting there chilling one day, and the hardship of your parents passing, and then you're like, damn, you know, it's the bittersweet of having this property passed on to you,
And then you're like, you know, you're counting all the chickens before they hatch. Like, okay, well, I know the property value is this, and I could take out some equity, maybe fix up the house, and maybe I could start having a little after party and make a little money for myself. You know, when the juices start flowing, and then one day in the mail, you get a fucking bill. $330,000 from the federal government because you inherited something. Does it get any worse? Like, what can you tell me that's possibly worse? What can you tell me that it possibly could be more fucked up than that? On such a level of 33%. First of all, I don't think there should be no tax on anything, on an inheritance. Well, that's two ways to stop white kids from getting that. You want to get banned? Yo. But it's true. He's like, well, that's two heads, yo. That's fucked up. Mikey Mystic with the comment of the day. Yo. Katina, good morning. Good morning. Morning, Adrian. Morning, Stacy, Nicole. Oh my goodness, yo, that comment right there made my morning. That comment right there really made my morning, cause it's true. Cause, yo, how you think the whole going postal came about? It was some bullshit like this. Some white privileged person probably was like, "This is not fair. God gave me my gun, and I will use it." And go and shoot shit up, man, because that shit is just not right. I don't know who he think he's hurting with that. Like your common regular folk don't own property. You know what I'm saying? Like how many Dominicans and Haitians and all these people who came from their native language and did not know how to speak a lick of English, worked their ass off to the bones just to get property. If you go in these nice neighborhoods right now, you see niggas. Milton, Shrewsbury, Stoughton, Sharon, you see niggas. They work hard for their property. So now they can't pass it along. You want now, so when they pass, their children gotta go back to the bullshit. One big circle, you gotta start over. Because I always bring it back to the, just some of the ignorance of some of the older people nowadays. Like, I used to have people's like my father and other people, they'll make little references like, when I was 25, I had my first house and blah, blah, blah. And I'd be like, yeah, but there was the HUD program. A fucking house was $60,000 back then. It wasn't all this bullshit. I mean, in times, it was a lot of money, but still, it wasn't the inflation like there was now. Yeah, you have programs and things of that sort now that help you out, but when you had to get 10% of 70 and 80,000 in the 80s compared to fucking 10% of a million, it's a fucking difference. It's a fucking difference. You know what I'm saying? And after all the scams and all the fucked up shit that went on, it's even harder now for someone of a I don't want to say ghetto, but just your common man to just walk up in a bank and just try to do common things. So without having the 750, 800 credit and all that, okay, sir, and they'll walk you right in. But if you're like, all right, here's a married couple, they both got 650, they both work 40 hours with overtime, some of them have 2 and 3 jobs, they're still giving them the runaround to get in. And then you're getting a runaround for certain areas that you want to fucking go in. And my brother was trying to buy a laundromat in Brockton, and it was giving him a hard time. And it was only one reason it was giving him a hard time. That nigga didn't want to sell to a black dude. He ended up getting the laundromat, but still. Those are the little shits that we have to go forth into getting our name and our 10 toes in the sand. So now our 10 toes are planted in the sand. We want to grab our children's hand, hold it, and let them know, yo, when I leave, your toes are going right here.
Yeah, his toes could only go there if you give me 100,000, man. That's extortion!
Can't get a home loan. You can get. Only thing they giving niggas is car loans. And they know, that's because they know niggas is stupid, buying shit we don't need. Let's be real about it. Let's think about it, y'all. So, I'm out of here. Big up yourself. Big up everybody checked in, chimed in. Ladies, as I said before, y'all know what time it is. Y'all know what's going down. Your phone is about to start ringing a lot more because it's officially cuffing season.
I want to dedicate this song to all the lovers tonight.
Big girls, you got to get that lingerie, take them pixies, get them all moist, and tell that nigga no. Tell them COVID gave you that stimmy and you paid your heat off.
When it's cold outside.
When it's cold outside. Tell them, nigga. You found another skinny nigga. That skinny nigga could cook. He cleans.
If y'all don't mind,
and he's getting that sloppy toppy because you know them big girls. They do that sloppy toppy. You gotta do it. Like I'm a superstar. So to the next one. Skinny fellas, get up on your P's and Q's. Big girls say they ain't having it. They'd rather be alone this winter than play with your funky ass. Stop playing with her emotions, man. Her moses is like a chicken bone. Can't be eaten and thrown away. You must cherish. Eat the chicken bone. Swallow. Cuffing season is officially here. Confidence, fellas. The big girls ain't taking it. They know their worth. They know what them pounds is worth right now. You know what I'm saying? Them pounds is hot commodity right now. Meat done gone up. The heat done gone up. Water done gone up. What you gonna do? Skinny girl can't do nothing for you until next June. If you won 52 and less, don't call my phone. You gotta have that right there, baby. If you don't have that right there, don't call me till June. Wait till it snows. You gonna be mad. You gonna be cold. Oh, oh. When it's cold outside. To the next one, y'all. My mother named Larry Jordan. That's my Russell opinion.